A Powermeter review in under 5 minutes? Let's give it a shot. Today, I'm diving into the 4Eyes Precision Powermeter. It's also known as the Precision 2.0 or the Precision 2.0 3D. The specs of what I'm looking at here and what I've had on the bike has been the Shimano R9100 left crank, so single-sided powermeter, the 172.5mm crank. It's available on Shimano 105 through the DuraAce cranks, claimed accuracy plus or minus 1% and plus Bluetooth smart. You get power and cadence from the unit. Battery-wise, takes a CR2032 battery with around 100 hours of usage, claimed weight of 9 grams. You will not notice it on the bike. Optimal operating temperature between 0 and 50 degrees C, and it is IPX7 certified. Depending on the model you go with, the price ranges between $349 US and $599 US. With the accompanying app from 4Eyes, you can do firmware updates, zero offsets, check battery status, change device name, device scaling up or down for power numbers, and also enable that Chipolo tracking for the lost and found feature they've released earlier this year. And when performing a zero offset on this power meter, it will return a helpful code, not just a zero or something random. If everything is okay, it will return 10 for the left side. If you have left and right for the dual side, it will return 10-10. Other codes are listed here, I'll put links below, but it's kind of handy to know things are a-okay after you perform that zero offset. Time check, okay, we're still looking good. Jumping over here quickly to DC Ramaker's analysis tool where we can compare multiple power meters as an overlay and see how they stack up. My outside ride here, 2 hours up against the Asioma Uno. I split my duos into the Uno, so I had left pedal and left crank recording. Fair decent ride here. We'll dive into the data for this climb here. 306, 309, within a few watts. Now, the way this records power, it's calculated differently to the pedal. Every different power meter will calculate differently. So you will get slight variances, and what we're seeing here in those slight variances are the spikes. So in purple, the 4Eyes is just a little spikier and the dips are a little bit lower, you can see here, but not too bad overall. Another little climb for some steady state stuff here and here. 254, 253, very close, but again, a little bit spikier. One short sharp acceleration, not quite a sprint here at the end, and the 4Eyes gets the jump on the Asioma Uno. It is the Uno, it does say Duo, that's just what I've got it labeled as, but it's a single-sided power meter on both, and they record just a little bit differently. It could be due to a number of different factors. A longer sprint's probably going to be a better test for this, but it wasn't too bad. Once things come into alignment, they tracked okay, and I was already done by then. Standard Llama lab test, a little short though, because there's nothing that's going to affect this with temperature. This unit does have active temperature compensation, so it should be good there. Looking at the Llama lab test, all pretty good. So we have the Asioma Uno, Tax Neo, and the 4Eyes DuraAce left only. Hard to compare directly with the Neo because the Neo is both left and right total power. The other two power meters are left only and doubled. So we have 229, 224, 223. Depending on how you want to read the tea leaves today, which one you think should read higher or read lower, depending on where things are at, it's close. But we can see the spiky one, again, is the 4Eyes, and it is spiking down quite a bit. For example, I picked one data point here, so it reads 177 for that specific point in time there. This is raw, unsmoothed. Why it reads 177? I'm pretty sure I wasn't doing 177 on the pedals at that time. Close though, very close. Into the sprint, this time the Asioma gets the jump. It's been flipped. That's just the nature of things with single-sided and the recording intervals. And then once time goes on after about 3 seconds, they all sort of line up here. It's close, no cigar. If you want killer accurate sprint power, get yourself a left-right power meter as close to the pedals as possible. Or the crank, or the spider. You know what I'm talking about, it's close. Just riding along, 336, 336, 338. Cool, happy days. Flipping to the overs and unders, I perform, and I had one hell of a dropout session there at the back half of the first 450 section. Other than that, all's looking pretty good given it's left and doubled, so it's going to be a little wonkier. Still a little spikier. Here, here, just short, and over here, when I do drop, and there is an actual drop, both power meters on the left do drop, the 4Eyes is just, again, it's a little spikier. And then just riding along, this short sort of harder effort there at the end. 155, 152, 152, all looking pretty good. Again, some red spikes there from the 4Eyes. Final time check, we're good, and time to wrap this one up for today. So in summary there, pretty much what I expect from a single-sided Shimano left-hand crank power meter. The numbers outside against the Uno, fantastic. Indoors, not too bad. But I really would like to see that data just smooth a little bit so we don't see that jumpy number on screen, even when using 3-second smoothing. So there we have it, my take on the single-sided 4Eyes Shimano-based precision power meter. Links below for more details on this, and as always, remember to hit that thumbs up and subscribe to this channel to support what I'm up to. Thanks for watching.